Hello friends, this is Coach Veer on my YouTube channel Coach Veer, and today we will discuss about Gauss Seidel method with the help of this problem. If you know this method, please try this problem and come again. Okay friends, before starting this problem, I have important work for you. Please don't forget to subscribe and share my channel. That's important for me, and put a like also. Okay friends, let's check this out. What is this Gauss Seidel method? How it works? So Gauss Seidel method is used to solve these linear equations with 1, 2, 3, 4, any number of variables. It is a numerical method, so it is comes under numerical analysis, and what's great about it, it converges very fast rather than your Gauss Jacobi method or other methods. It is faster than that, and why it is so, that I am going to show you. But before that, there are few requirements for this. First requirement is that it must be diagonally dominant. That's very important. Means the diagonal elements, if you change this into AX is equal to B form, which is the matrix form, this equation, you know, A is the coefficient matrix of all this X, Y, Z, B is this all other side of the equal to, and X is the vector of this X, Y, Z. So we need to find the value of X, but how we can solve this by making it diagonally dominant? Diagonally dominant means in the diagonal, if you see a matrix, this principal diagonal is this, and so if you make the X of this as the biggest, Y of this is the biggest, Z of this is the biggest, and that must be absolute value, means sign does not matter, whether it is positive or negative, that does not matter. So let me assemble this in a manner, like I know this one is having the biggest X value, so this must come the first. So 27x plus 6y minus z is equal to 85 is our first equation. Then I need to search for the y, bigger y. And in this, I am going to find the bigger y in comparison to other variables coefficients. Okay, so I can take this as second equation, 6x plus 15y and plus 2z equal to 72. Okay, now the third one is only this one left, so let me write this, and you can see the z value is having the biggest coefficient, 54, so x plus y plus 54z is equal to 110. That's our the three equations which we have got from this, and now it is having diagonally dominant form. Now it is, you can say, just a minute, diagonal dominant. Okay, there is another analogy also, symmetric and this thing, but let not go in that thing. Let's work it out. So what we need to do is, first we need to utilize this equation and write it in the form of x equal to. So let me write that in the form of x equal to. If I write it as x is equal to 85, this 66y is going in subtraction, this z is going in addition, and this 27 is going in the denominator of this, or you can say divide of this. Okay, same way happens with this for the y. And okay friends, y we can write as y is equal to 1 upon 15. This 15 is going in the division, that side, and you have 72 minus 6x minus 2z. Okay, same for the z, you can form this equation, and this equation will give you 1 upon 54 and 110 minus x minus y for this. Till here you will going to get 2 marks in your question if this question is given for the 10 marks. So what about after this? For Gauss Seidel method, what you need to do is initial values. Let the initial values for the value of y as 0 and for z as 0. Okay, let's substitute that in the first equation. When we substitute it in the first equation, we are going to get x is equal to 1 by 27 and this is only 85, as this all are going to be 0. So let's write it 0 and 0. So 85 divided by 27 will give you approximately 3.148. You can do that with the calci is allowed in this. Okay, now further, for this you can say y value, if you want to calculate, so 1 by 15 divided by this 72. Now here comes, what is the value of x you are going to put? X value which you have just got, that value you have to put. And you can say it is the first iteration. Okay, this is the first iteration. Like that, many iterations can be possible till the value of our approximation is ascertained. So these are x1. So this x1 can be put it here in place of this 6 times x1. So I will write 6 times 3.148. And then I close the bracket. I will put the value as negative 2 times of z. Z is 0. Okay. Then we do all these calculations. That's a Kelsey part that you can do. 3.541 you can get. Okay. I'm taking 3 digits after decimal. So z also can be calculated by this. Or you can say z1 as it is the first iteration. So you get 110 minus x1. This you have to put 3.148 negative of y1, which is 3.541. When you do all this calculation, you are going to get 1.913. Okay. So here is our first iteration for x, y, z. Same way when you calculate for the second iteration, how that can be done. Same way means which you have got x1, now you have to find for the x2, which is the color. So x2 can be finded by this only 1 by 27, this 85, now 6 time of y1, 3.541, and plus z1, which is 1.913. When you calculate all this, you are going to get 2.432. That's easy. See, it is just a pattern you need to follow. And same for the y2, you can do 1 by 15. Here is the thing. Like when you are going to put 6 times this thing x, okay? 6 times x. So x must be this, not x1. This is x2 now this time, 2.432. So you need to put z as z1, 1.913. And so on. You can calculate it easily with the help of your calculator, and you are going to get 3.572. Same way z1 and z2 can be calculated, 1 by 54 divided with 1 0 this x1, not x2, you have to put here 2.432 negative of y2, 3.572, and you are going to get here after with the help of calculation, let me close this bracket, 1.926. I have done all this calculation with the Kelsey, so not to worry about that. So we got values, like you can see they are very close, and this is a little bit different. So when you do this all calculations, you are going to reach to a point which is very much similar to this. And after the fifth iterations or fourth iterations, what I am going to get here is x is equal to 2.426, y is equal to 3. You can try this iteration with the help of Kelsey and following the same method as practice makes you better. So this is what I am going to get up to 3 digits accuracy. So you can judge z is our accurate at this time, and somewhat of y2, but there is a little bit chance of accuracy in the x. It is converging very fast. Hope you understood this, and let me recap a little for you. What we have done here in this question is, first we have to think about diagonally dominant, means diagonal element must be the largest one among all the elements. So we reassemble this in this form so that we get x as fast, bigger, y as and z as the biggest one in that whole equation's coefficients. Now we form x is equal to a equation for the first one, for the second one I have done it for the y, and the third one I have done it for the z. And with the help of initial values as 0 and 1, you can take any other values, 1 or 1 also, or any value, it's not prominent. Okay, now when you substitute these values, you are going to get a iterations like that when you substitute this. But what's great about Gauss Seidel is you need to take the last value which you have find it. Just now, like we have find it here x values as x1, so we have substituted this value here in place of x1, and same way we got y1 value and we substituted this y1 value here. So that is the only concern in this whole, and in our Gauss Jacobi we don't do this. That's what is important in this case of Gauss Jacobi method and Gauss Seidel methods, as well as their differences are concerned. Hope you have understood this. Thank you for watching this. See you in my next video. Bye.